Eid Mubarak again to anyone, every one of you, inshallah, and even those who are watching online. The day of Eid holds great importance in Islam. It is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deemed you worthy of it. And that is what we say in the Qunut, that Allah has made this Eid for the Muslims. And therefore on this day, we are told to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will remember us, and we are asked to glorify and praise Him and pray to Him. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us with a united Eid for the Shias almost all over the world, starting from India, Pakistan, Middle East, and Africa, Europe, and the Americas. I'm not sure about the situation in Australia, but you know, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Interestingly, this year, even the Saudis are with us, which was a surprise anyway, but anyway. This information about Eid days in different parts of the world, different continents, this information was not possible for us, you know, 100 years ago. We would be in our own region, our own confines. We will look for the moon. If we see it, we follow it. If we don't see it, we do the Eid the day other than that. You know, and we will know about other cities, other countries, after a week or a month when we get a maybe a letter from a relative. And so it was, in a way, a peaceful time, I think. You know, now everybody sits there. Oh, you know, in India it's already cited, in Iran, in Iraq it's already cited. And anyway, that has its own excitement. But I think this is where we are to realize that this is a moment of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the intelligence and the power that He has given us to human beings to exploit the nature and create the most advanced tools and technology by which we can communicate and see one another through the internet from any part of the world to any other part of the world. And this is something we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a side note, I would like to even, you know, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the opportunity that we had of introducing the moon sighting tool in the website during this month. And last night was the first major, you know, test for it. Alhamdulillah, we had about 20 reports, beginning with Halifax on the east coast of us, going on to New Brunswick, Quebec, Ontario, all the way to Vancouver. And even before that, we had Pennsylvania in the south, Orlando also, as well as Chicago and Denver. And so, and there were more than, you know, there were thousands of people who actually went to the website to know about the real-time situation of the reports of moon sighting. And this has really helped us on the Crescent Committee of the Council of the Shia Ulama to make the decision much fast. So even before it was sunset here, we had already declared the Eid based on the sighting in the East Coast. And so I would like to urge those who, you know, thank those who participated in that process and, you know, keep watching for it. Yes, there is no Eid next month, but, you know, make it a habit to go out and look for the Hilal, and you know, inshallah, that will make things easy for us, and you will also be part of that process, inshallah. The Quran actually talks about the elements of nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created for us, and He has made the world subservient to us. And this is something he talks about it in different ayat. Very quickly, I will go through them. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ وَالنُّجُومُ. Allah is the one who made the day and the night and the sun and the moon and the stars subservient to you. And then he says, وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارُ. you know, even the rivers, he made subservient to you. Allahu alladhi sakhkhara lakum al-bahr, he is the one who also made the sea subservient to you as human beings. Another ayat he says, alam tara anna Allah sakhkhara lakum ma fi as-samawati wa ma fi al-ard, do not you see that Allah has made everything which is there in the heavens and the earth for you? It is subservient to you. In another ayah, it says, سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مِنْهُ. Everything is there for you. And when Allah uses this term, تَسْخِير and subservience, what it means is that either it is for our benefit or he has given us the ability to control them. And this is something we have to, you know, think about it, that everything is for us, but we are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The eclipse that we just had on Monday, and we did namaz-e-ayat, that was a reflection of that, that that is the part of the, you know, power and the system that Allah has created. We don't bow down to the sun and feel afraid on that day. The sun is for us. We are not for the sun. We are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this is the sense that we have to realize, you know, he has given us the power. We use the water, the wind, and the sun to generate power. We can connect to the people around the world globally now, and this is how we have mastered the technology, even to travel through the space. And these are examples of the taskhir that he has made for us, for this world and the space around it. And so when you look at all these ayat that are mentioned, you will see at the end, he end, you know, three types of, you know, messages. He says, these are la'ayatin liqawmin ya'qiloon. I made this thing subservient to you, and these are my signs for the people who use their mind, who use their aql. In another ayat, he ends by saying, "La'ayatin liqawmin yatafakkaroon." You know, these are the signs for the people who reflect in order to appreciate and understand the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In one verse, he says at the end that I have made everything subservient to you, la'allakum tashkuroon. Hopefully, you will be thankful to me. And so this is the moment to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings that he has given to us. I would just like to mention two or three, you know, issues on a collective basis here. Number one, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ability to observe the month of Ramadan as a community and cater to the largest Shia congregation in North America. And this would not have been possible without the support of the volunteers that we have who work in the center as well as outside the center. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, bless them and reward them in the dunya and the akhirah. Secondly, you know, it's not just this congregation that we see here every night in the month of Ramadan. You know, our AV team uses advanced technology as a musakharat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to share our message and content with the rest of the community on an online basis. You know, people from different parts of the world regularly, you know, tune into our programs. And thirdly, I would also like to single out the ECO team for playing our small part in maintaining the health of the environment. And that is also a good, you know, habit that we learn during the iftar process here. And so I would like to end this khutbah with this recurring ayat in Surah Ar-Rahman, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. You know, so which of the bounties of your Lord will you both, the jinn and ins, will deny? And our response is, لَا بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ آلَائِكَ رَبِّكَ نُكَذِّبُ. Wallah, we do not deny any of your bounties, inshallah. إِنَّ أَحْسَنَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ قَدْ أَفْلَهَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى وَذَكَرَ ثُمَّ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الواحد العهد الصمد الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المجتبى وعن عليا أمير المؤمنين وعن ذريته المعصومين أئمتنا What is the lesson that we have learned from the fasting of the month of Ramadan? I would like to just speak on one theme, which is from Dua-e Makarib al-Akhlaq. Unfortunately, we only recite it in one of the Shab-e Qadr in month of Ramadan. Remember, Dua-e Makarib al-Akhlaq is not for Ramadan. It is for all the time. That is just a way of introducing knowing to know that there is a dua known as Dua-e Makarim al-Akhlaq in which Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salatu wasalam talks about the noble characters and he talks about it from different angles and it's a long dua I know but this is something at least once in a while keep that in your mind to recite that with translation. One of the important things that there is a sabq ila al-fadila, competing for the virtues. I don't think when we talk about religious issues, virtues and fadail, we don't have this concept of competing against one another for it. We are familiar with the competition in education, career, business, sports, mashallah, the communities are very much into it, But we need to focus perhaps more on the competition on a very different plane and dimension. And that is competing for the salvation in the eternal life, in the hereafter. You see, those who do not believe in the hereafter, they are busy competing and running for the comfort of this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses this term where he says in three places in the Quran, yusari'una, they are hastening. Yusari'una fil kufr. They are hastening towards, disbelief. Another ayah says, yusari'una fil ithm wal udwan wa aqlihim al-sukht. They are, hastening and going in their competition for sins and for rebelliousness, and for eating the haram. They do this because in their views, the life ends with death. And so their competition basically is focused on planning for this dunya, for the old age, for the retirement only. And I am not saying don't plan for your retirement. What I'm saying that if you believe that there is something beyond the retirement, there is a barzakh after that, and there is akhirah after that, then our perspective would be different. And that's where we have to focus on this hastening and the competition and running for something else. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the same words. He says, yusari'una fil khayrat. Those who believe in the akhirah, they actually run and compete for in the field of goodness. So to run in the field and track of goodness and virtue, especially when it comes to charity, is an important lesson that we learn from the fasting of the month of Ramadan. Especially if you look at the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the daily namaz, dua after dua, after the namaz where we say, Allahumma adkhil as-surur fi ahl al-qubur. This is, if you look at that list there, we are told to be concerned for the poor and for the needy and for those who don't have decent clothing, for those who are hungry, those who have been displaced from their homeland, those who are innocently in the prison. And this is where, you know, even concern for the oppressed people around the world comes in. And that is why our sympathy and support for these Palestinians in Gaza becomes more pronounced during the charity in the month of Ramadan. And so when we talk about this, you know, field and track of good character and virtues, what is the goalpost? What is the prize at the end that you're looking for? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it. He says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْعَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ سَارِع means, you know, go fast in that run, in that competition, towards the maghfira, forgiveness of your Lord, and towards the Jannah. That is your end there. And the Jannah, whose, you know, space is like the heavens and the earth put together. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, which has been prepared for the righteous people. In another ayah, it says, سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ أَرْضُهَا كَأَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْعَرْضِ. You know, سَابِقٌ means try to be ahead of others. Again, the concept of, you know, competition in virtues. You know, be مِنَ السَّابِقِينَ, towards the مَغْفِرَة of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgiveness of your Lord, and the Jannah, whose expansion is equal to the heavens and the earth. أُعِدَّتْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ, which has been prepared for those who believe in Allah and His messengers. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, that is the grace of Allah, He gives to whomever He wants. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Dua Kumail from our Imam Amir al-Mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wa salam. If you look at the last passage of that dua, even there, one of the things that you ask Allah, that you, Allah, bless me, hatta asrahu ilayka fi mayadin as-sabiqin wa usri ilayka fil baridin. You know, Allah, give me the ability so that I may pass quickly towards you in the field of those who are foremost. It means there is a race going on of the good people, and you want to be among those who are sabiqeen, who are in the front. وَأُصْرِ عَلَيْكَ فِي الْبَارِذِينَ, and those who hasten towards you among those who are fast in their move. And this is where we have to realize that, remember, the competition for dunya is fine, but there is a more important competition for the virtues in the Akhirah. It's not that you shouldn't be working for your dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, one last message. وَابْتَغِي فِيمَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ. You know, by the means of what Allah has given to you, seek the abode of the hereafter. But then immediately says, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبُكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, but do not forget your share of this world. Use this dunya for your Akhirah. You can't, build your Akhirah in the Akhirah. There's no material there, no money there to buy anything. Whatever is there is here. And this is where we have to realize that, you know, we should use this dunya for the Akhirah, and of course not forget our temporary abode either. اللهم صل على سيد المرسلين وخاتم النبيين سيدنا ونبينا بالقاسم محمد. وعلى إمام المتقين علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله عليه. وعلى سيدة نساء العالمين فاطمة الزهراء صلوات الله عليها. وعلى سيد شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم الصلاة والسلام. اللهم صل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي عليهم الصلاة والسلام. اللهم صل على الحجة بن الحسن القائم بالحق المهدي.
الذي ببقائه بقيت الدنيا وبيمنه رزق الورى وبوجوده سبطت الأرض والسماء.
I need to translate this. Who is the Mahdi? He is the one. By his existence, the dunya exists. And it is by his grace that the people are sustained. And it is because of his existence that the heaven and the earth are still standing.
وَبِهِ يَمْلَعُ اللَّهُ الْعَرْضَ قِسْطًا وَعَدْلًا كَمَا مُلِئَ الظُّلْمًا وَجَوْرًا وَعَجِّلْ لَنَا اللَّهُمَّ ظُهُورُهُ إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا بِرَحْمَتِكَ يَا رَحْمَ الرَّاحِمِينَ.
اللهم صل على محمد.